Say 2 weeks ago I made a video about, say, an organ circuit, and I needed a sawtooth generator for that, and that's why I published the schematic of this sawtooth generator that finally was finished approximately a week ago. You can set the frequency, you can invert the signal output via a capacitor of 100 nanofarad and a direct output volume control. And here are the frequency switches. A little bit complicated because I did not have a mother switch with one central contact and three other contacts. So I had to do that with switches that only have two contacts. Anyway, again, that beautiful magazine of 1968, and I told about this circuit with the neon tubes, etc., etc. But now I have a want to make a vlog about this part of the article of 1961, and that's especially about these three filters that are, in my opinion, very interesting. The magazine tells us that when you send in here a sawtooth wave of a certain frequency, this filter will change that into the sound of brass copper instruments. The output here, input here, output here, and you see here two coils. And I've made a kind of, say, principle of proof of principle circuit. And when you add a signal to this part, this filter, this will be a wood wind instruments, the sound of wood wind instruments, also made with coils and filters. And here, string instruments. That's, in my opinion, very interesting. Show it again. Mind that we have here certain rules of thumb. C1 is equal to C2. R1 is equal to R2. Well, I cannot say directly how that must be calculated out, but anyway, when you study it, I can read here 4 times R3, 8 times R4, and here also rule of thumb indications about the resistors, and of course you need the values of these resistors, do that in a proper way, to get the right sound. I have made a proof of principle circuit, and I did not follow exactly this. Anyway, it takes too much time to do all these experiments and find out their conclusions. But I tried to make this part of the circuit with two coils. I did not have specific coils. So I used an old transformer from 230 volts. To say 12 volts or so. It's a kind of mini transformer. It's here. And I wired it into the circuit. And here is, in fact, the filter unit. And that filter unit is mounted between two transistor stages. Here is one, the first one. And this is the second one. Of course, not immediately clear how all the wiring was done, but this is the schematic. So this is the proof of principle circuit. You can mount, wire in that filter, this filter, or that one, between two one transistor amplifiers. So that when there's some loss in the filter, you can lift the volume up to, say, the right level. This is what I made. It looks a little bit like the filter in the magazine, but in fact not at all. This is the same part, and here it's changed somewhat, but my only aim is here to make a vlog, so no very specific things, only something to tell when you want to do these kinds of experiments with audio filters. So let's listen to what this filter brings. And I now disconnect this part here, this part of the filter. Now connect it again. Disconnect. Connect. So, I leave it on, but to stop the music now, and let's see what happens when we use the sawtooth generator and at the same time watch the scope. This is of course not a pleasant sound, but anyway, here is the waveform on the scope, and what I wanted to show is this, that when I remove this capacitor here, you can hear a clear effect. And that is in fact the same sound that you heard in the music, the change in music that you heard earlier. But now with a sawtooth generator, with a sawtooth signal at the input and the signal tracer at the output. Do that again, and now I will lift up the frequency between 1 hertz and 1 kilohertz, and let's see how that filter works in that band, frequency band. Take out that cap. Connect that capacitor, wire the capacitor in, 170 hertz approximately. Clear effect. And now we go to the frequency where the filter works at its best. So this is the central frequency of the filter made with this setup, with this simple 230 volt 12 volt transformer that I used here as an inductor to reach certain sound effects. The sound, I don't like the sound, but anyway, let's go higher. This is what we see. Remove that cap. And we are now on 700 hertz. Now we go to the highest frequency. And you can see and hear that on 1.7 kilohertz there's no effect any longer from this filter. So this is a filter that works between say 50 hertz, approximately 1 kilohertz, and it has its best effect on approximately 400 hertz. So that is a part of the low frequency band, and that also makes that we hear a more smooth sound when we use this filter. We'll try to put on the music again. Take some time. The music. Hope that it starts. Even kijken. One moment. Sorry for that. The music, where are the plugs to the music? This has to work. Anyway. So, I don't know why it didn't work. I have to switch it off again because it didn't work, but I explained it in my opinion in a proper way and have showed the properties of such a circuit that can be used as an audio filter, and especially to give the music a more rich sound in this case, and of course say to change a certain frequency, one frequency or something between frequencies between say 300 and 500 hertz, and give it another sound character. And of course this is all old school technology with modern synthesizers, and even with the cheapest synthesizer you can do this trick. But of course it could be very interesting to do experiments. Try all kinds of transformers, listen to the sound, etc., etc. You can also mount here a capacitor parallel to one winding of the transformer and another capacitor here. That makes, in theory at least, the frequency band more sharp. And this is also important to tell. These are two transistor stages, but there must never be a direct connection between the collector of this, the first transistor, and the base of the second transistor, of course, because we shortcut the collector to ground in that case, and we shortcut the base to ground, so the circuit will not work at all when there is a direct connection, direct wire between these two electrodes in the circuit. So always, more or less always, use here a coupling capacitor, and use bipolar coupling capacitors for this purpose. Electrolytic capacitors have, say, the bad habit that they leak a tiny current, and that can take a transistor out of its bias, out of its working point. And that means distortion, at least on the longer term. You can use this also for a speech filter. I've tested that. One wave, one music, etc., etc. An interesting circuit to do experiments. And you can spend a lot of time with this circuit. Could be a pleasure.